Hi friends, welcome to Hind Mind. Jai Hind and wish Happy Republic Day to all my fellow Indians. I am your host Sudipta Pathak. We all know and we are proud of it that India is the largest democracy in the world. Today we have a strong army and showcasing our military equipments on Rajpath. But initially it was thought that we would not need a military as no one will attack a peaceful democracy. Thankfully, we were proved to be wrong just after independence. Kashmir was attacked by our most favored nation and neighbor Pakistan. In 1962, we were attacked by China. But in 1967, we gave them a bloody nose in Sikkim. Since then, we fought many wars and the latest was in 1999 in Kargil. There is no doubt that it is the man behind the machine who wins the war. But the probability for month-long full-scale war has become very low and chances for tactical battles in limited area were increasing. It was clear that to fight a conventional war, we needed something mighty, like the ancient weapon Brahmastra, which can change the outcome of a war. We needed a conventional missile, which can strike fast, strike hard, and should be hard to detect and deter. Yes, I am talking about Brahmos missile. Brahmos was developed by Defense Research and Development Organization of India and NPO Mashinostroinia of Russia, taking P-800 Onyx as base design, with India-specific modifications and named after River Brahmaputra and Moskva. Brahmos Aerospace Limited was established on 12th February 1998 with a capital of $250 million, where India holds 50.5% share and Russia holds 49.5% share. On 12th June 2001, the first Brahmos was launched. And since then, Brahmos Block 1, Block 2 and Block 3 have been developed. An air launch version and submarine launch version has also been developed for Indian Defense Forces. Block 1 is the basic version. It has two variants, anti-ship version and land attack version. Indian Navy is equipped with Block 1 and Indian Army is equipped with one regiment of Brahmos Block 1. Block 2 has improved land attack capability with an upgraded radar seeker for precise hit. Block 3 has an advanced guidance system using G3OM chip and upgraded software, incorporating high maneuvers at multiple points and steep dive from high altitude. The steep dive capability of the Block 3 enables it to hit targets behind a mountain range. In this video, I will show how Brahmos missile works. Let's check this speech. This shows the internal structure of the missile. It has 5 subsystems: the airframe, guidance system, warhead, control system and propulsion system. I have made 3D model on the basis of this image. Let me show you. This is the 3D model I have made. Let's talk about the airframe. The missile has a cylindrical body with air intake on the nose to maximize the airflow and reduce drag. When the missile is stored inside the canister, it has its wing folded tangentially to the cylindrical airframe. There are ribs on the airframe to support the airframe within the canister and prevent friction between the wings and fins with the canister wall. When the missile is ejected out of the canister, the control fins gets into position like this. Then the nose cap separates so that air can flow through the ramjet. There are 4 explosive charges which acts like a rocket and pulls the cap outwards. Now let's remove the outer body and show the internal structure. At the nose there is the radar seeker. Then the control system. Behind the control system is the warhead. Then the solid fuel rocket motor along the spine till the end. Outside of which is the fuel tank for the liquid fuel. Behind the fuel tank is the actuators. Behind the actuators are the sustainer motor for the ramjet engine. Brahmos uses a combination of satellite navigation and internal navigation throughout the flight path and switch on the radar during the terminal phase. This is the older radar of Block 1 variant and this is the new advanced imaging and monopulse radar which have a weight of just 50 kg and a 20 km range. The seeker has been developed by Defense Research and Development Laboratory and Electronics Corporation of India Limited and manufactured by Data Patterns. For the navigation purpose, Brahmos uses G3OM chip which is GPS, GLONASS, Gagan on a module which has a weight of just 17 grams and gives accuracy below 5 meters. Thus, the Brahmos became the only supersonic cruise missile having advanced capability of selection of a particular land target amongst a group of targets, providing an edge to the user with precise hit. You can see the black part on the model, which is the position of the warhead in the missile. The Brahmos has a 200 kg conventional semi-armor piercing warhead, but the sheer amount of kinetic energy of the missile itself is enough to knock down a small warship. Due to the high speed, it works like a huge kinetic energy penetrator or explosive blast, completely destroy the target from inside. Now we will discuss about the control system. Control system is located just behind the radar system. It contains all the gyros, satellite navigation system, internal navigation system, altitude measurement system, and the autopilot. The missile movement is controlled by the actuators using the control fins behind the stabilizing wings. The actuator is connected through the connectors situated inside the safety tube. Now let me show the fin movements. Now we will talk about propulsion system. Brahmos has a solid fueled rocket motor which acts as booster to gain certain speed, after which the ramjet can take over. The red section you see is the solid fueled rocket motor. The green section you see is the fuel tank which holds the liquid fuel to be used during cruise flight. The yellow section is the sustainer where the compressed air gets mixed with the fuel, and when ignited, the ramjet is started. Let me show you the flow path of the compressed air within the missile. Let me remove the outer parts so that you can see the airflow clearly. Thank you friends for watching this video, and special thanks to Mr. Prasun Kumar Sengupta and his blog trisultrident.blogspot.com.